Hey everyone, it is Scott from CertMedia.com, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you an awesome free plugin called Lazy Load for comments. So in the A3 Lazy Load video, I talked about how it can improve the load time of your website by lazy loading videos and iframes, which basically just meant that your browser will not download those images or videos until they scroll to show to the user. So basically, if you have a foot image in your footer, but the user never scrolls to the footer, they won't download that image, which reduces the number of bytes they need to download if they're on a data connection, but it improves their load time because they don't have to wait for that data to be sent for the page to be fully downloaded. Lazy Load for comments is along the same concept, but for the comments on your articles. Having a website where you are having an active comment base is good for your SEO, but it's also very challenging from a performance point of view. One thing that people try to do is offload their comments to a service like Discus or Facebook. That way they don't have to worry about the impact on their browser, on their browser's rendering speed, but they don't have to impact their server either to handle the processing of the comments. So what happens is when you're using the native WordPress comments and you get a very large number of comments, in this case, I auto-generated 112 of them, you start to notice that you're going to start getting some performance issues. Most of the scrolling, for instance, on this is due to the comments. I ran a GT matrix report as well to help illustrate the impact on the DOM size. So there's 2,906 DOM elements, most of which are originating from the comments. And as you can also see, there's a substantial number of gravatars, even though they are all coming as the same image, the mysterious person. So not only is the browser now having to download all of the HTML for your comment section, they have to download every image, even though it's the exact same image. This is one of the inefficiencies in Gravatar, where if one user has the same Gravatar as another, they're still treated as two entirely separate URLs. So the browser has to download each and every one of these little images. Now, using a plugin like A3 Lazy Load will cut out these requests here on the initial load. However, A3 Lazy Load will not solve the DOM size issue. And the only way to do that is to use Lazy Load for comments. So Lazy Load for comments, when you install it, you get a new menu under the discussion settings. You could choose to not lazy load, lazy load on click, or lazy load on scroll. To illustrate what happens, I'm going to set it to on click. That way you can see what actually is going on. So I'm going to refresh this page. And the one thing you immediately notice is the scroll bar is way smaller. So we can automatically assume now that the comments are indeed not there. And as you can see, it's left with the load comments button. This can be easily styled with custom CSS. This is just whatever the 2019 theme decided it would look like. And to load the comments, all they have to do is click this button. You get a nice little image, and then the comments load in, and the DOM size will balloon. So to illustrate how this can improve, I'm now going to run a second GT matrix test. GT matrix isn't a perfect testing tool by any means, but this is a good way of grasping the immediate impact of loading comments on your website. So we're going to go ahead and let this run. And what I'm expecting is notably the request to drop because we're no longer downloading the gravatars. And I'm also expecting that DOM size to be substantially smaller. So we're going to go ahead and let it go. And it looks like it has hit the varnish cache. Of course it did. You can never have an easy test without varnish getting in the way, can you? So we're just going to go over to my Cloudways real quick, and I'm going to purge my server cache to remove that issue. And if you're doing this on your own website, you probably ran the test and you already saw the reduction. That's always going to happen by lazy loading these comments. But we have Varnish. So Varnish always likes to be a little bit of a persnickety server-side cache. All right, there we go. We're gonna run it one more time and hopefully we should see that amazing improvement that I was just referring to. You can also set it to lazy load on scroll, and whichever method you choose is really coming down to how you want to interact with your users. If you have content in the footer that you're not trying to bury under your comments, then I do recommend you set it to load via the button. And as you can see, the improvement that we just had was quite dramatic. Remember, we're loading the same image, but from a bunch of different URLs because Gravatar isn't efficient, which so we reduced our page size by about 140 kilobytes. We reduced the request count down from 122 to 19, and we reduced the fully loaded time dramatically, but that's mostly because of all the images we're downloading. And our DOM size, which was originally 2,900 elements, now passes and it doesn't even flag you anymore. This is a pretty substantial improvement. We still have 6 Gravatar requests because the theme loads them in the header naturally, so you wouldn't have this unless you're also using the 2019 theme or your own theme does a little bit something interesting. But back to the discussion settings, the on-click method is my preferred method if I'm working on a website where they have a large amount of comments. But if it's a website where the comments are the primary reason people go there, meaning when the website is created and you're writing a post, you're trying to immediately engage with the audience and your footer is less of a concern, then I set it to on scroll. It's also a good thing to do if you're trying to keep the interface, the user experience a little bit more seamless. So if you set it to the on scroll, then the users just get a nice little loading bar and they don't have to click a button. So if you're concerned about the comments decreasing, I recommend you set it to on scroll. That way users don't even notice really the impact that they're getting. But if you're just strictly going for performance and you want to optimize what's showing in your footer and you want to lead users to other pages without setting your comments up in multiple pages, then on click is also fine. And then one more note would be you can break comments into pages, but as has been covered by Yoast SEO and a couple of other outlets, the problem with this method is it splits your post into multiple pages. So what happens is if you split the comments into pages, I'm going to show you what happens on this one. Remember, we have about 112 comments, so I'm going to set the amount of comments per page to 20, and we're going to reload. The DOM size is immediately smaller, but what it happens is when you get to the bottom, you have to now click to go to the previous comments. So now you get your URL with comment-page-5, and now it's splitting the number of pages that users have to click through to read the rest of the comments. This is not really good, and if you don't have proper canonicals in place, what can also happen is comment-page-5 may be indexed as its own separate page. The issue with that is your rankings aren't typically coming from your comments. It's going to be coming from the content of your blog post. So what happens here is you're splitting the number of pages. If they both get indexed, you could get hit with duplicate content warnings because you're having the same post indexed for multiple URLs. So just make sure you have proper canonicals in place and that your devs haven't done anything particularly odd. But I just don't recommend you use this method at all. Lazy loading the comments is just a much more efficient means of improving your load time without really having any weirdness going on with your URL schemes. If you have any questions about this plugin, please feel free to ask in the comments below and I will try to help you out. I'll include a link to it in the description below. You should certainly check it out if you have a very active comment base. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching and goodbye.